We're back with more warnings about books that may hold more than just a story. The origins of many of these curses are so ancient, it is not clear how they became attached to these stories. There seems to be something about the emotion of writing a story that invites dark spirits to attach themselves to the words. These books should definitely stay on the shelf, or you might not live to see another day. So let's jump into the top 5 scary books that hold ancient curses, part 2. In at number 5, we have Tamino's Hell. Okay, so this one is a poem rather than a full book, but it still holds an ancient curse that it is worth sending a warning about. It was written by Japanese writer Seijo Yasso. Not much is known about the writer. He published the poem in 1919 in his 27th collection of poetry. Seijo lost his sister and his father during World War I. It is said since that happened, he was in a constant state of suffering and grief. Since the poem gained its reputation for the curse, many have given their opinion how the book became such a danger. Many believe that Seijo was vulnerable to demons while he was in his suffering state, that he might have been persuaded to do their bidding to ease his pain. He allowed them to curse the poem in such a way that when it was read out loud, it would cause those who heard it to suffer. It is unknown if Seijo was aware of the consequences of his actions when he published the work. The work itself seems to almost confirm this, as it follows a young boy who has suffered loss in his descent into hell. When the poem was released, there quickly came reports of sudden passings. One woman is said to have died moments after reading the poem out loud. Others have complained of chest pains, sharp pains in their brain, along with many other severe symptoms. Many people got sick, and others passed away suddenly from illness or bizarre accidents. The one passing that was most famous was that of Japanese filmmaker Tarayama Shuji. Shuji made a film based on the poem in 1974. The film was believed to have been cursed by the poem when Shuji passed away suddenly shortly after it was released. The book has since become a terrifying legend, and those who know of it try to avoid it at all costs. In 2004, the writer Inuhaiko published a book based on the poem. This brought the poem to a new audience. Since then, more people have found the poem online to test if the rumors are true. Those people reported weird occurrences and horrific accidents after they read it. In at number 4, The Book of the Sacred Magic of Abramelin the Mage. The Book of the Sacred Magic of Abramelin the Mage is a book of mystic arts written by Abraham for his son Lamech. It was a 3-part 15th century book. It was translated in the 1900s. Once translated, it developed a reputation for being cursed. Abraham wrote his book based on the idea that every person has their own unique personal demon. The book contains rituals to help the reader summon and control their demon. It's told that once you could do this, you could perform supernatural feats. It is said that if you own this book, you will also get the attached curse. Anyone with a copy in their possession will be haunted by spirits from another realm. People unlucky enough to own the book have had bad luck follow them, and some even met an early demise. It is said that the incantations that give you the ability to control your demon releases the curse and opens you up to demons from the other side. Fun stuff. In at number 3, we have The Great Omar. Some call The Great Omar the most cursed book of all time. Unlike other books in this list that might unleash a curse on the person or people who open it, the curse is often contained. This book, however, has been linked to many great tragedies throughout history. People were captured by the beauty of this book. The beauty of the binding hid the curse from the world and enchanted buyers. The book was embellished with over 1,000 jewels, with 5,000 leathers on lays and 100 square feet of gold leaf. It took the team of craftsmen over 2.5 years to make. Only one was ever made due to the grandeur of the book. When the book was finally completed, it was sold at auction for £1,000 and shipped to New York for display. The book went down on the Titanic and was destroyed. Some say it was due to the book being on board that the ship went down when further misfortunes followed anyone involved. The creator of the book drowned while trying to rescue a woman a few weeks later. His partner decided to recreate the book. Again, this was a long and painful task, costing him a lot of time. Once the second book was created, it was placed in a vault in London. He wanted it to be reserved so that it would not meet the same fate as the first. Unfortunately, the vault and the second crater were both destroyed in the bombings of World War II. Was this a coincidence that both books and craters were destroyed? Some think that an ancient curse latched onto the book on creation. This then passed to the second on creation. Was it due to the story inside? Little is written on the book. People only ever paid attention to the cover. This may have been by design. The company that created the book then passed on to one of the previous owner's nephews. After his retirement, he decided to do a personal project and recreate the book. This copy lives in the British Library to this day. I would not risk attempting to touch or read it, though. His past seems like a clear warning. In at number 2, we have the Grand Grimoire. The Grand Grimoire is also nicknamed the Gospel of Satan. It is an occult book written by a man in the 15th century. Little is known about the man who wrote the book, but he is believed to have been possessed by the devil. On completion of the book, the devil passed from him into the book. The book is known to be cursed by the devil. You're advised to not attempt to read this book. A grimoire is a book of spells. The particular spells in the book are dark and twisted. Often some form of sacrifice is needed to complete any of the spells. You would need to be willing to perform some truly evil acts if you wanted to be successful with these spells. A lot of people look for this book due to its promise to be able to bring loved ones back to life or summon demons. Many people who are grieving loved ones who passed too soon try to use this book to bring them back. This is extremely dangerous, and not only will it may not work, but it might backfire and cause your own demise. This book has such a dark reputation, it has been the most feared book since medieval times. Of course, it goes without saying that you should avoid this book, really any book that promises it can summon demons, as that is usually a big sign that it might be cursed. Catcher in the Rye? What the f***? Everyone's read this book. I'm not possessed. Maybe. And finally, in at number 1, we have The Catcher in the Rye. The Catcher in the Rye is one of the most well-known American books of the 20th century. It is often a required reading for most teens during high school. Despite this, the book has a dark past that often gets overlooked. It was written by J.D. Salinger and first published in 1951. The book is considered to perfectly capture the essence of adolescence. Throughout time and the changes in society, it is still relatable to teenagers' lives today. It reflects the true nature of being an adolescent, the rebellion, survival, and internal struggles of growing up. Follows the story of a young man named Holden Caulfield. He has been kicked out of a number of schools, and when the story picks up, he has been kicked out of his latest school. He does not want to tell his parents, fearing the punishment that might follow. He runs away from home and starts his adventures in New York. At the time of its release, it was seen as controversial for using bad language and adult themes, but the author didn't want to censor the book. He wanted an accurate depiction. None of this is why the book is considered cursed, though. The curse comes from the link the book has to murders. The list of crimes linked to the book is longer than you might expect, one of the most famous being the assassination of John Lennon. His killer sat and read the book until the police arrived. He then used the book to write and sign his confession. He later explained that after reading the book, he wanted to save Lennon and maintain his innocence forever. This is not the only famous murder connected to the book. Robert Bardo took the life of actress Rebecca Schaefer, and John Hinckley assassinated Ronald Reagan. Both were carrying copies of the book while committing their crimes. It is unknown why this curse turns people into killers, or how this book became cursed. It appears that it has the power to turn certain readers into criminals. It seems that it does not have the ability to make everyone behave in the same way. Maybe if you read the book at a low point in your life, you'll be susceptible to the curse. So there is a chance you'll read the book and be fine, but there is a risk that it will intercept your mind with the dark thoughts. It seems to make the reader believe they need to cleanse the world. So if you do have to read this, please just be careful. Well, there we have it. Do you guys agree with our list? What is the scariest book you have ever read? Leave us all your thoughts and feelings in the comments down below, and perhaps we can do a part 3. And on that note, if you haven't already, be sure to give this video a big thumbs up, and until next time, I'll see you later. We're back with more warnings about what books hold more than just a story. Amazing, what a way to go in. That is not even grammatically correct. In 2004, the writer Yomota in who? This brought the poem to a new, what the f***? Going to smash things. It might backfire. Oh wait, that makes sense. Huh? This is new information.